NASA wants Elon Musk's SpaceX to ensure its plan to launch its next-generation Starship rocket from Florida would not put at risk nearby launch infrastructure, critical to the International Space Station, a senior space agency official told Reuters. The new hurdle further complicates and could potentially delay the launch plan for the rocket, which faces an already protracted regulatory review of its primary launch site in Texas. Musk wants to show customers that Starship, which he sees as humanity's path to Mars, can successfully reach orbit, a long-delayed pivotal milestone in the rocket's development. SpaceX's proposals to address NASA's concerns, which include a plan to be able to launch U.S. astronauts from a different launchpad in Florida, could take months to get agency approval. SpaceX last year accelerated construction of an orbital Starship launchpad at its facilities in Cape Canaveral, Florida, as an alternative to the rocket's primary test launch and development site in Boca Chica, Texas. But one of SpaceX's existing Florida facilities, called Launch Complex 39A, at NASA's Kennedy Space Center on the coast of Cape Canaveral, is the only pad approved to launch the company's Crew Dragon capsule. NASA depends on that spacecraft to ferry its astronauts to the International Space Station. NASA officials in recent months have told SpaceX that a Starship explosion at Launch Complex 39A could effectively cut off the space agency's sole means of launching U.S. astronauts to the International Space Station. "We all recognize that if you had an early failure like we did on one of the early SpaceX flights, it would be pretty devastating to 39A, Kathy Lutters, NASA's space operations chief, said in an interview of the agency's discussions with SpaceX. SpaceX did not return a request for comment. SpaceX has already invested heavily in building a Starship pad, some hundreds of feet from Pad 39A's launch tower. It has responded by pitching NASA on a plan to outfit its other Florida pad, Launch Complex 40, 5 miles away on Space Force property, with the means to launch U.S. astronauts, according to a person familiar with the plans. The company is also studying ways to harden 39A, or make the launch pad more resilient to both an explosive Starship accident and the immense forces emitted from a successful Starship liftoff," Lutters said. "Hardening the 39A pad and launching humans from Pad 40 would both require agency approval. SpaceX is working with us on those things," said Lutters. "Because it's also in their best interest to not have what is a pretty steady source of income for them become interrupted. Part of SpaceX's challenge is to show that 39A will not be damaged by Starship's novel liquid oxygen and methane fuel, a combination of propellants that NASA and U.S. regulators are not familiar with. The problem is the explosive potential for that combination is not well known," said Randy Repchek, a deputy manager in the Federal Aviation Administration's Office of Commercial Space Transportation, which oversees launchpad safety. Starship is a two-stage reusable rocket system designed to launch commercial satellites to Earth orbit and humans to the Moon and Mars. NASA last year picked SpaceX to use Starship for the agency's first launch of U.S. astronauts to the lunar surface since the days of the Apollo program. The rocket's next big test, a complex task of launching to orbit for the first time, has been delayed in part by the regulatory review of the Texas compound's environmental impact, which has precluded the FAA from granting SpaceX its orbital launch license. Set to conclude Monday, the review is expected to place conditions on SpaceX that could add delays to its Starship program. That prospect led Musk to double down last year on construction of Starship's launchpad at 39A in Florida at Cape Canaveral. "We do have the alternative of the Cape, and we actually applied for environmental approval for launch from the Cape a few years ago and received it," Musk said at a Starship update event in February, estimating it would take 6 to 8 months to build up the Cape launch tower and launch from there. But the preparations for Starship on the East Coast are continuing to build up, both at the Roberts Road and LC-39A sites. 5 launch tower sections have been constructed at Roberts Road, with segments 1 and 3 having more hardware installed in their floors, such as handrails on the outer perimeter and in the elevator shaft. The elevator shaft is also getting a grating that acts as a safety barrier door. These 2 segments are labeled as levels 1 and 5, which are the tower levels directly above the concrete base, and the level for the quick disconnect arm, respectively. Level 5 is also gaining the initial hardware needed to support the QD arm. Since the segments were assembled in a different order, then they will exist on the tower itself. Segments 1, 2, 4, and 5 correspond to tower levels 1, 2, 3, and 4, respectively. These segments can be seen with a raceway installed on the corner opposite, from the side of the tower the launch mount will be on. This raceway will eventually get outfitted with the wires, conduits, and other ground support equipment, to be used for all the power and fluids needed for the tower, to support its own Mechazilla system. The foundations for High Bay 3, or the Cape Mega Bay, have been seen with concrete poured over the rebar. Cross bracing for HB3 is stored by the GSE pipe production area to the north. These cross braces will go in between the primary steel columns, and beams for added structural reinforcement. Then all of that will get covered by the panels, that form the external facade of the building. Next door from there, the foundation work for the Starship factory is progressing, with the pile driller doing more work near Roberts Road itself. Elon recently shared a render of how the Roberts Road complex will look, once all significant work is done, and this cosmetic work can be seen, on that same corner of the Hangar X building. It also shows the opening for vehicles, to enter and exit High Bay 3 will be on the north side, and the Star Factory will feature two different roof heights, likely to accommodate nose cone and payload bay stacking. However, these plans appear to be somewhat fluid from a final design standpoint, with NSF's Harry Stranger spotting updated schematics of the Roberts Road factory plan, which could actually include two high bays. At SpaceX's Launch Complex 39A, where the Starships built at Roberts Road will launch, all the legs for the Starship launch mount are finally in place. Also observed is the base for the giant crane, that will help build the infrastructure for launching and landing Starship rockets at LC-39A. It remains to be seen what type of crane will be used, but potentially it could be an LR-11350, the same type of crane used for tower assembly in Starbase Boca Chica. Given the arrival of the crane at 39A, and the state of the launch tower segments at Roberts Road, the rollout of the segments to 39A and stacking on the concrete base started. The remaining concrete pours needed to complete it has occurred, with more work also ongoing on the future location of the draw works for the Mechazilla system. Once the concrete cures, the first launch tower segment will be stacked on top of it. Wood cribbing or crane mats is being stored by the two tents south of the launch mount. These will be used as a surface for moving and distributing the weight of the massive crane being assembled there. Nearby, several supports for GSE lines are also visible to the north of the launch tower, and over at the former Starship landing site by the two tents. Following the utilization of Starbase and 39A, SpaceX will then work on additional options, such as two pads at LC-49 and its two ocean platforms, Phobos and Deimos. Thanks for watching this video, and it's a super interesting topic. If you like this, make sure to subscribe. If you have any crazy ideas about what we should cover in next video, please comment it below, and we'll see if we can get to it. So thanks again for watching and goodbye.